This video is going to describe how to merge different boards on one panel in DipTrace. First of all, if you want to combine several PCBs on a panel, open the respective Panelized projects and select the one where you will prepare the panel for manufacturing. It's recommended to panelize boards with equal number of layers. I'm gonna use this project. Let's save it as PCB panel. Now I'll go to File, Layout Information, to check the board size. It's almost 131 by 122 millimeters. I move on to another project I want to panelize. The board size is 73 by 65 millimeters. So this allows me to place two of these boards along 131 millimeter side of the first board, leaving just enough space in between for subsequent cutting. Let's go back to PCB panel file. Check Keep Ref Des While Pasting in the Edit submenu, and the software will keep all the reference designators of the pasted layouts unchanged. This allows to avoid automatic shifting in numbering of reference designators of the components with the same markers in the designs being combined on the panel. Besides, if you have a DipTrace license that limits the number of pins, with this option enabled, the software will not sum up the pins of all the layouts, so the pin limitation of your DipTrace edition will not apply. Basically, we are going to copy boards to one project. But since there can be only one board outline in each PCB project, we'll have to convert the board outlines of the panelized layouts to board cutouts. To do that, right-click on the board outline and select Convert to Shape from the submenu. Next, press Ctrl+A hotkeys to select all objects, Ctrl+G to group them, and Ctrl+C to copy. Go back to PCB panel project, right-click on the design area where you would like to insert the layout, and select Paste from the submenu. Use R or Space hotkeys for 90-degree rotation. Let's add another board here. For convenience, you can hide silk screen layer. The current distribution is suitable if you are going to cut and assemble the board manually. Remember that if you are going to use routing to cut the boards out of the panel, the optimal distance between them is 2 mm. However, if your design contains some components extending beyond the PCB boundaries and you are going to add automatic assembly, you should leave enough space for such components on the panel, or in some cases it makes sense to rotate the board to take advantage of the real space. Please note that those are only general guidelines, so remember to consult your fabrication and assembly partners for specific panelization requirements. Now I'll zoom in and go to View, Define Origin by mouse pointer, and right-click in the bottom left corner of my PCB to set the board origin point. Once the boards are distributed, you can add a panel edge and a router path if required. I'm going to change the grid size and make it 5 mm. Next, to create a panel border, I select Place Board Outline tool and draw the outline 5 mm away from the border of the layout. Right-click at the endpoint and select Enter. For more details about creating router paths with mouse bytes and preparing the panel for automatic assembly, watch Panelizing in DipTrace Part 1 that covers panelization of identical boards. When combining different boards, the procedure is essentially the same, with the only exception that since we are not using panelizing feature, you will have to create a router path and tabs for each board individually. If you are panelizing layouts with copper boards and need to update them after pasting, you can use the following approach. Since updating copper boards is not possible within board cutouts, the workaround would be to temporarily convert them to shapes of some other type. For example, transfer a cutout shape to silk screen layer. To do that, double-click on the shape and select Top Silk from the Type drop-down. Update copper pour and convert the shape back to a cutout.